Declarative versus imperative, making that choice never grows old. It is the what versus how question. SQL is declarative. HTML is declarative too, did you know that? Imperative coding has its merits, true, mostly in performance, sometimes. But most of the object-oriented code I see around is imperative for no reason at all. I want you to correct that, because once you adopt the declarative coding style, your code will start looking lovely. Let me show you. Here is a demo application. It is modeling a bookstore, letting users inspect and buy books. The book's price is affected by one or more discounts, as you can see here. That feature has significant complexity already. And it will keep growing further because customers, they are knocking on the door, bringing fresh requirements straight from hell. Let's hear them. This is the book details page implementation. That is where the new requirements are coming. This call will give us an object representing all the discounts applicable at the moment of execution. That object implements this interface and it models any combination of concrete discounts that may apply to a book. That is where the new requirements are coming in. Customers also want discounts that are based on specific data about the logged in user, the geographic location of the web request, time of the day, and a few other pieces of information gathered from all over the system. There are many concrete implementations of the iDiscount interface already in this project, and more classes will come when we start implementing these requirements. This feature is the most complex part of the application, and if you implemented any retail domain in your career, you must know already that price calculation is by far the most complicated part of retail. I want you to see how complex the system of discounts already is before adding new requirements to it. And the new requirements will make it grow even further. The customer's imagination, it knows of no bounds. I am thy customer, I shall return. You know that feeling. We usually address the issue of open-ended requirements by grouping the moving parts into a separate type. I'm creating a new type, which I will call the selling context. This type, or the object implementing this type, or anything deriving from it, should contain everything that defines the context in which the website user is making a purchase. It will contain a nullable book at this moment. It is nullable because discounts might also apply in places where there is no book. But there will be other things that affect the purchase. I'm making this a record because I want to keep things as simple as possible. I don't want to add complexity of my own on top of what customers have already dumped at the back of the backlog. And so we are here in the iDiscount interface definition and we must augment it now. This is where you decide, and this is where declarative design and declarative coding style will start helping us. One possibility is to ask the callers to supply the selling context. But the problem is that this type, which is very simple at this moment, will grow large very soon and very quickly. All that complexity will pour into the unsuspecting concrete implementations of this interface, making them much more complicated than they are right now. Can we do it better? Of course we can. I wouldn't be here if I didn't see a better design for this interface. Rule number one of software design: if it starts to become complicated, delete it and start over. That feature bothered me already. It is adding complexity to many other methods and classes. So I deleted it. But the trouble is that complexity will never go away. The complexity is part of the domain, and so it must be represented in my software solution. The complexity will be there, it's only the choice of the place where to put it. Therefore, I will add a separate method to deal with this piece of complexity. Not much of ingenuity, right? But think again. Introducing a separate method for this feature is a game changer. The first improvement is that the two complex features are now implemented by the two separate methods, not by one giant one. The second improvement is that now I can use the default interface implementation, a relatively new feature in C#. Many classes in this project have nothing special to do concerning the new feature, so they won't even have to write any code to implement it. As a developer, I love doing nothing. The best code you can write is the one you don't write. But now comes the greatest mystery of this design. This method assumes mutability. Why? Is there any benefit from mutating the discount object? I don't see it here. Without evidence that we need mutability, I will make this method immutable. I always do things like this. The default implementation will return this unchanged. And I have just led you into a trap. The trap of declarative coding, because look, what would the object returned by this method represent? What is it? Not what it is doing, what this method is doing, but what is the object it returns? I have just switched to declarative speaking. Did you notice that? Call this method and ask the object to give you a version of itself which is applicable to the context. The change of mindset. Yours is to tell what you need, not how to construct it. This change is the redesign, so I must fix many classes already implementing discounts. If you think that is bad, cheer up, it would be much worse if I left it the old way. New requirements are coming in and the problem of mixing responsibilities would only grow larger. Restricted discount is the base class for all discounts that are sensitive to the context. It is an excellent place to demonstrate the benefits of the new design. Look at its implementation, it is awful. The main feature of this class will now become trivial now that the two responsibilities are separated. And the other responsibility, filtering by the context, will belong to the applicable to method. When put into a selling context, the discount either remains or turns into no discount. I would have to fix other classes too, but you don't have to watch that. That comes with a redesign. I better sustain this much damage now rather than twice that much tomorrow. And that leaves us with the consuming class alone. It is the only place where we do know the book which the user is watching or trying to buy. And that is where we would create a selling context around that book, right? Not so fast. Let's imagine that we have already started implementing the other requirements, those regarding the logged-in user, the geographic location of the web request, etc. Those parts of the context lie outside this class, and therefore this Razor page will receive a pre-populated context via dependency injection. I will inject an empty context for the sake of running the demo only, but you can imagine implementing a middleware, for example, which would populate the context object with all the relevant data from the current web request. Back to the consuming place, we have obtained all the discounts configured for the application, and we have the context that is populated with the data that do not depend on this page's content specifically, and so we must remove the discounts that do not fit the current request. We need discounts applicable to the context as we have received it, plus the piece of information known to this method, specifically the book. Another declarative piece of code, this time utilizing the non-destructive mutation of records. Very nice. And the discount amounts now only depend on the price and nothing else. This change is small but pervasive. As you adopt the declarative coding and design style, in many other classes in your design, you will start noticing this same simplifying effect as you can see it here. Change your mindset. Stop telling objects how to implement the features you need. Start asking them for an object which has the attributes you need. Your code will become easier to understand, easier to develop further when new requirements arrive. It is not a miracle. It is another day at work doing declarative design.